smooth melodic sound of Emeli Sandé first made its mark 10 years ago, but you could be mistaken for thinking it was only yesterday. Qualified neurologist, Emeli sidelined study for songwriting, sending fans into a frenzy with her platinum-selling single Next to Me and following it up with a string of hits, including some very famous and very soulful collaborations. Would you let me see? After winning 4 Brit Awards, selling 19 million singles and taking time off to become a university chancellor... Yeah, you heard that right. Emeli is back with a new album and things are looking up. It's gonna be brighter days, brighter days. Though it seems distant, know the world will change to brighter days.
Yeah, but how many NFTs has she sold? Sorry, Emeli Sandé joins us now from London! Hey, thanks so much for speaking to us. Great to have you on the show. Congrats on the new album, by the way. And the song we just heard there at the end is Brighter Days, one of the singles from it. Can we just take a wild guess that this was written during the pandemic?
Yes, you'd be absolutely correct. I made the whole of this album in lockdown during the pandemic, and one of the main objectives with the album was to make something that would uplift people, make them feel better, more hopeful. So I hope it's doing that now it's out.
Emeli, it's been a decade since your debut album smashed records, outselling Adele's 21 album. How has your sound evolved over that time?
Well, definitely on this most recent album, I feel I've been a lot more free to discover and explore new genres. So, you know, I think people are used to me being on the piano singing, but now on this album, I've explored a lot of disco, some R&B, 80s sounds, and I've got a lot more into the production. So I always try and do something a little bit different from the last album.
Emeli, you recently came out on Instagram with such a lovely message to your fans. When I was reading it, it was so beautiful. And I thought of you as you were pressing send, like you wrote this beautiful message. What was that moment like when you hit send? Where was your headspace at? What was your heart like? Were you looking for comments or did you just throw the phone away and get on with your day?
It was a little bit nerve-wracking because you're never sure how people will react, but I definitely got to a point in my life and in my relationship where I just felt like I wanted to be free. I wanted people to really know the real me. So it was a bit nerve-wracking, but I was just so overwhelmed and touched by the response and the acceptance from my fans. I feel like a new person now. It feels fantastic.
Well, Emeli, we can hear that freedom in your new work as well. You also, of course, have written for other superstars like Alicia Keys, Katy Perry, too. What's that process like and how does it differ from your own process when you write your own content? And now that you are exploring different sides of production, are you going to mix it up as well?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, music should be an adventure, but when I'm working with other people, I know I try to get to know what they want to say, because at the end of the day, I'm just there to kind of facilitate that. When I'm writing for myself, I just let it all, you know, free flow out. But when you're writing for somebody else, I love it if we can actually be in the studio together, which you don't often get the chance to do. And you just sit down, talk, and then slowly, you know, their story gets to be told. But I really enjoy it. You know, I loved working with Alicia Keys. She's a fantastic woman, and I learned a lot from her.
And you give them your bad songs, yeah?
Emeli, you decided...
Oh, not a denial! Not a denial!
He's not letting it go. He's in a mood, Emeli. I'm going to save you. You decided to pursue a career in music over becoming a doctor, I read. I mean, Indian girl, Indian parents, I can only imagine how they would have reacted if it was me, but I'm guessing they would have come around when you sold about a bazillion records.
Yeah, luckily it all worked out. But yeah, it was a big thing for my dad. My dad's Zambian and his whole journey has been through education. So it was a big thing for him, for me to graduate and to go to university. And luckily we did the graduation. He was very happy. And once I did that, then I felt free to go to London and pursue, you know, my passion of music.
Can we talk about your chancellorship, by the way? We don't often include that in a setup package on musical guests. It's very rare that we say this. So you were appointed the Chancellor of a university in the UK. This was just before the pandemic. And I understand the first thing you did was award your parents' degrees, which is wonderful if you're in a position to do that. Why did you do that?
Well, it's a university called Sunderland University, and that's where my parents actually both went. That's where they met. That's when I came about. You know, I was a bit of a surprise for everybody. So they didn't actually get to attend their graduation back in 1988. So it was an emotional moment getting to be on stage and actually hand their degrees to them after so many years because, you know, they weren't able to attend the original one.
And Emeli, I have to ask, with your new work, what do you hope that your fans feel when they're listening to it?
I really hope that they feel a sense of confidence. I really wanted to make an album that gave them a space to either escape or heal in. So, yeah, I hope the songs really touch their souls, touch their hearts, and that they get to know me on a deeper level as well.
Oh, well, so they certainly will, and they also get to dance around a bit too. Emeli Sandé, thank you so much for your time. It's been wonderful having a chat to you, and you can thank get you. your hands on her new album, let's say, for instance, when it drops tomorrow. Emeli Sandé, wonderful chatting.
Thank you.